Once upon a time, humanity sought laws from heaven, and the God himself gave humans the creeds. There were many families throughout the earth, and those who observed the creeds were known as the men of creeds. And these men of creeds condemned all the outsiders and the violators of the creeds. However, no one dared to point out the errors of the men of creeds, for these men were greatly feared. And yet, those who observed the creeds could not avoid these errors. They wove darkness to cover them. Failures gave birth to shame. Shame gave birth to darkness, and darkness to corruption. Blind they became, and tainted became the divine creed. For in this trespass, the men of creeds now received a nickname, hypocrite. There were also the men of Samaria. They were hated by the men of creeds. The men of Samaria had a wise man for their boss. He wanted to make a truce with men of creeds. He wanted to stop the condemnation of his Sumerian family. However,
boss, we got a problem. Our men have been hit with men of creeds.
Tell our boys to gather up. Killed my men. I have photos to bring your family down. The world will know all of you are guilty of treasonous acts.
How dare you try and stand against us? Know your place. You're merely men of Samaria. Every boys, by the way. You don't want them dead, you'll meet me at the church in Hilltown. You give me the photos, and you and your boys are free to leave.
Boys, then we're gonna negotiate. We're gonna call the photo.
This isn't a negotiation. It's a funeral.
Thank you. Father, they will never learn. They will never understand. They don't know who you are, Father. Please, Father, let me go. Let me become a human and fulfill the creeds. I will be the one who represents the whole world.
My son, then what of their crimes? Will you also receive the penalty of their errors?
I'll bet he's with men of Crete. Why is he trying to talk to me? Well, why does he care? I'm just nobody. Wait. Unless he was the Christ, the Messiah. I heard of him before.
Are you the Christ?
Yes, I am the Christ. I came to save you.
Righteousness and eternal life, so that they can be considered righteous through my work, my finished work. If they accept me, they will become your heirs. They will wear my righteous robe and garments of eternal life, and I will send them my spirit, so that we can all be united, and your promise with Abraham will be fulfilled. Your son.
You are the Christ, a Savior, a King, who gives your righteousness to purchase my sin, who gives eternal life to buy my death. Thank you. Thank you for your righteous robe. Thank you for your life that you laid down for me. Thank you, Jesus.
I know what enthusiasm they have for God, but it is misdirected zeal, for they don't understand God's way of making people right with Himself. Refusing to accept God's way, they cling to their own way of getting right with God by trying to keep the law. For Christ has already accomplished the purpose for which the law was given. As a result, all who believe in Him are made right with God. All who depend on the law, who are seeking to be justified by obedience to the law of rituals, are under a curse, and doomed only to disappointment and destruction. For it is written in the scriptures, cursed, accursed, devoted to destruction, doomed to eternal punishment be everyone who does not continue to abide, live, and remain by all of the precepts and commands written in the book of the law and to practice them. Now, this is evident that no person is justified, declared righteous, and brought into right standing with God through the law. The scripture says, the man in right standing with God, the just and the righteous, shall live by and out of faith. And he who through and by faith is declared righteous and in right standing with God shall live. But the law does not rest on faith, does not require faith. It has nothing to do with faith. For it itself says, he who does them, the things prescribed by the law, shall live by them, not by faith. Christ purchased our freedom. He redeemed us from this cursed doom of the law and its condemnation by himself becoming a curse for us. It is written in the scriptures, cursed is everyone and anyone who hangs on a tree. What purpose then does the law serve? Is the law then against the promises of God? Certainly not. For if there had been a law given which could have given life, truly righteousness would have been by the law. But the scripture has confined all under sin that the promise by faith in Jesus Christ might be given to those who believe. But before faith came, we were kept under guard by the law, kept for the faith which would afterward be revealed. Therefore, the law was our tutor to bring us to Christ, that we might be justified by faith. But after faith has come, we are no longer under a tutor. For you are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female. For you are all one in Christ Jesus. And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
Now Jesus is alive, Jesus is alive.